John Swanson, 1894 to 1925. We had a very successful business in life. We hauled 200 loads a week. It was very hard to get that many loads. We loved logging. We were the richest brothers in town, and we wanted to spend our money. All my brothers had to draw straws to see who got to go with me to get the car. Of course, I went because I was the oldest. When we took the train down to Chicago. When we got down there and got the car, we did not know how to drive it. It took forever to get it right. We drove into Encampment. Everybody came out to see what we were doing. It was like a parade. 16 years after we got the car, my brother Billy was cutting a tree. It fell the wrong way. I turned and the last thing I saw was a tree coming down on me.
Caleb Baker, 1883 to 1907. My name is Caleb Baker, named after my uncle Caleb Jones. I knew my life was cursed from the beginning. Nothing good ever came my way. Very few people even knew me, because I practically lived at my work. On the bright side, I had a few close friends. My job was hot, dirty, hard work. I hauled buckets of copper ore around. I wasn't the smartest person, but I was a good man. I was working at the smelter one day, and out of nowhere, this huge explosion happened. All I saw was a flash of bright light, and then complete darkness. And then the day of my funeral, not even a full funeral, or so a partial one. Some people came, most of them didn't. I wish I could have done so much more with my life, but here I lie, and I haven't learned any bad thing.
Caleb Jones, 1858 to 1888. Are you serious? I tried to turn my life around and this is how I get repaid? Are you kidding me? I go from being an outlaw to come settle with family, just minding my own. But no, because I was part of Billy the Kid's gang, I get shot by a sheriff who was looking for fame. That sheriff was Yellow Belly Scum. I was a man of sin, stealing, fighting, and killing. I acted tough, but on the inside, I was soft. I knew I was doing wrong. But I made a commitment to Billy, and those aren't meant to be broke. I rode with Billy for 10 years. When he was shot by Pat Garrett, I set out on my own. I was stuck on becoming a man of the straight and narrow path. I headed north because I heard word from my sister of a new nephew. They were having financial problems and needed some help, so I rode 3 days. In less than 8 hours after my arrival, I was shot and killed by Sheriff Everhart, just because he noticed the face of a man on a wanted poster. Now that I'm dead, I find out that that sheriff was a hardened criminal. Not only did he shoot me, but he murdered his wife and 2 children. Now I'm buried in this damn town with that bloody sheriff in this cursed cemetery.
Peter Everhart, 1850 through 1898. Between the day I was born in 1850 and the day I died in 1898, I had no regrets. In fact, I had fun my whole life. Sure, the pathetic townspeople of Encampment gave me a little trouble when they found me outside my burning house, my wife and 2 children still screaming inside. But because of my badge, a few rumors couldn't lock me away. So instead of tearing me down, the locals, they turned it into some type of exciting new sport for me. I even joked about it with a few drunks that still drank with me. Then the notorious gunslinger, Billy the Kid, died, and that idiotic gang member showed up in my town. So, thinking of my thrilling new sport, I gunned that man down, just outside the town limits. It didn't take the townspeople long to figure out that I had murdered that man. But instead of treating me like a murderer, they treated me like a hero. Shoot. They even voted me in for mayor. I got remarried to a young, spirited girl who cheated on me constantly. But before I could punish her for her deceitfulness, I died. The townspeople, they gave me the best funeral, and I was placed on the top of the best hill in my town's graveyard. I have no regrets.
Ella Birch, 1913 to 1928. It all started with a boy named John. I was 12 and he was 15. The things he made me do became normal to me after about a month, and at 14, I became pregnant. I had no idea what to do. John had left town and left me alone here with our child. When I told my sister, she promised it would all be okay, but my sister was wrong. Raising this child was the hardest thing I had ever had to do, mostly because I actually did not want this baby, but I raised him for a whole year by myself, and then the unthinkable. John was back in town and looking for me. He had decided he was wrong and should have stayed. John came to talk to me, telling me how sorry he was and that he felt responsible for any troubles I had had. But I wished he had stayed gone. I was angry now that he was back. Why? I was not even sure myself. I was confused about what to do. I could not run, but I could not let him help with my son. Out of turmoil and anger, I killed my son. I killed him and threw him in the river. Heartless? Maybe so, but I thought it was my only choice. When John found out, he was furious, his face the reddest I had ever seen. It didn't take long before he blew up and beat me to death.